The National Association of Resident Doctors of Nigeria has commenced a nationwide strike after the expiration of a 14-day ultimatum. NAD President Dr. Aliyu Sokomba said the union has decided to exempt its members working in various coronavirus isolation and treatment centers across the country. According to Sokomba, the union took the decision to go on strike as a result of the failed series of meetings between the doctors and the federal government in the last 2 weeks. Amongst their demands include stoppage of illegal deductions of salaries by some state governments and failure of government to provide life insurance for doctors and other health workers in the front line. Joining us to speak more on this is Dr. Stanley Iwogu, Publicity Secretary of the National Association of Resident Doctors. Thank you for joining us on the news.
Thank you for having me.
What other demands are you making apart from the illegal deductions of salaries by some states and other COVID-19 related issues?
Okay. Well, the very first demand from the National Association of Resident Doctors is a provision of adequate personal protective equipment, such as hazmat suits, N95 respirators, surgical gloves, and masks. These personal protective gears are meant to protect the health workers from getting infected with the coronavirus. As we speak now, we already have over 800 of our members exposed to the coronavirus. 200 of those members have tested positive to coronavirus, and 10 of our members are already dead from this virus. So we felt we cannot continue like this. We cannot continue to risk our life while trying to protect Nigerians. So we felt we should get the state and the federal government to provide the necessary personal protective equipment to all of us so that we can continue our.
Okay, the period of grace that you gave before you commenced with the strike, was there a meeting between your association and government to try and stop the strike from taking place?
Okay, yes. On the 30th of May, 2020, after our ordinary general meeting, we issued a 14-day ultimatum that elapsed on the 13th of June. That was on Saturday, and following that, we summoned emergency national executive meeting, which held yesterday. And after that, we looked at the responses from the government, and we felt they've been insincere with our demands. And we decided to commence an industrial action this morning.
The question many are asking is, why now? Some say it is an act of blackmail because of your invaluable role, bearing in mind that there is economic downturn everywhere and the coronavirus pandemic.
I beg to disagree with that. First of all, the first case of coronavirus infection entered this country on the 27th of February. And for over 100 days, that is 3 months, we've been working actively at every level, helping to curb the spread of this dangerous virus. Bare hands. As I speak to you now, I've never received any personal protective equipment from the hospital management where I worked as Anambra State up till now. All the personal protective gears I procured them myself with my personal money. So we feel we are getting infected. Are we going to die? We remember we have families, we have children. How are we going to, what will happen to them if at all we lose our life in this battle? And as we speak, I told you, 10 of our members are already done and there is no life insurance cover for them. So we want those personal protective equipment to be provided to us.
Well, if that is one of your reasons, doctor.
In any form.
Hello, doctor. You said one of the reasons is the lack of protective gear to do the work. But in the prelude to this conversation, there were indications that people that are working at the isolation centers and helping to contain the virus were exempted from this strike. How true is that? And how does that connect with you saying that one of the reasons is the lack of PPEs?
Thank you very much. To start with, patients that end up in the treatment center do not present directly to the treatment center. You agree with me that once a patient gets sick, the very first thing he or she does is to move to the nearest general hospital or tertiary hospital or even private hospitals. And at that time, some of them can be asymptomatic, or they may even be symptomatic with COVID symptoms. And such people are seen by our doctors who are frontliners in accident and emergency and our general outpatient clinics. At that point, I can get infected with this dangerous virus. So those people who are in all those places also need personal protective equipment. Now, we make this diagnosis of COVID-19 or suspected COVID-19 before we now send their samples to NCDC laboratories, and they are now tested and moved to the treatment center. So you see, nobody goes straight to the treatment center. Now, coming to treatment center now, some of our members are also working at the treatment centers. And now, that is why we have decided to add a little human face to this struggle. That is why we have said in the first two instances, or in the first 2 weeks of this house, indefinite strike, we are going to allow those of our members who are still at the treatment center to continue giving their care, rendering care to Nigerians. But that does not mean that we will not record them at a particular point in time if government fails to do the needful.
All right. So I'm sorry to keep interjecting. While we wait for government's decision, in the interim, what happens to the patients? Would you reconsider? Should government remain adamant? Or will you stay with the strike as quickly as you can, sir?
The truth is, the decision to embark on this strike was taken by all the National Executive Council members from across the country, and we looked at the dangers that we face on a daily basis without adequate protection, and that is why we have decided to embark on this strike. To be frank with you, once government does the needful, we will go back to work, and hopefully we expect them to do the needful. They need to come to the negotiating table and discuss with us, so that we can get back to work. We are not strike mongers. We don't want to continue the strike. We want to do everything possible to get back to work.
All right, Doctor, thank you very much for explaining some of the grievances you have, and we're looking forward to a peaceful resolution of the matter in the nearest future. Thank you very much.